that song called Who Would Be Blue from 1925. Seven figures on Honky Tonk Barbecue, I almost said. This is nice. Where's the tip at? It is Sunday. In fact, we're playing at Honky Tonk right now as we speak. That's kind of weird. Yeah. Well, Jimmy pulled a thing out of the book and he said, what's this?
Yeah, we're going to find out.
We're going to find out. We should do our march event. No, we're not
here. Here's the first court. Here's the first court.
Our thing recorded by the Broadway Bellhops from 1927. Let's shoot for the great Big Spider, Beck and Cornet, and Frank Trumbauer on saxophone, and Don Murray on clarinet. I call this A Cradle in Carolina. Caroline Hubbuck, the tenor sax of Natalie Sharp, and clarinet from John Otto. To replace that god awful vocal. No, I'm kidding. Oh, I'm kidding.
Give him another shooter.
Another shooter. We're going to play a three reed number here, like three saxophones. been recorded and written by Clarence Williams and Fats Waller. It's called Charleston Mound. Paul's going to sing it for you. And, Arf. Dave Bach on the tuba. Yeah, right. Oh, right. Hey, how about Dave Bach's trombone playing this weekend with Hale's band? That's pretty good. Yeah, first time in 3 years on a gig, right? Yeah. He gave it up and then came on back. Couldn't quite walk away from it. All right, this is a song from 1930. That was discovered for us by our old banjo player, remember Johnny Donatowicz? And he found this thing on the internet radio station. It was written by Harold Arlen, one of his first songs. Kind of a bit of a favorite of the band's. This is called Out of a Clear Blue Sky. Thank you. Suicide. That's a perfect. No one plays that, but no one plays anything from Clay.
Okay. I said Jimmy never.
I said Jimmy doesn't take years ago. I left the shower. Right. We're going to play a song now from 1923. It goes way back. And recorded by Fletcher Henderson, featuring a young Coleman Hawkins on tenor saxophone. This is not. And this is our own arrangement of it, but kind of reminiscent of Fletcher Henderson. And we're going to feature Nellie Sharp on tenor saxophone. This is ripped from the headlines of the Warren G. Harding administration. Y'all remember that? This is called the Teapot Dome Blues. And we're going to do the Scopes Monkey Trial. What's that song? Evolution Mama, Don't You Make a Monkey Out of Me? Teapot Dome, please.
Thank you.
going shoes. That's not Cole Porter. Shut up.
Shut up.
4 seconds. All right, so who knows about the Brian Ruff discographies? You know about those things? Basically, if you don't know what they are, they're big books. It lists like every record ever made in the 20s, jazz record or hot dance things. But they list things that weren't ever issued too, because they found the file cards. And one of them is called, the band is like, what, Blind Gilbert's Tin Roofers? It's a New Orleans band. I don't know any of the guys on it, but they listed the titles, and we don't know what they sounded like. And one is, well, Clarinet Marmalade. One side is a sequel, I guess, called Cornet Omelet. It's pretty cool. And the other one, who knows what the hell this thing is, but I wanted to use the title so bad, so I wrote a song out, a new song, using the title, and it's called Dump Cart. And it's becoming a fan favorite at the Green Bone Honky Tonk, I think, so.
Yeah,
it is
a good one.
All right, here. For your approval, Dump Cart. Thank you. Brown.